I got a couple little chicken scratchings over there. Well, I'm delighted to see you all, and we have a great show for you. It's down at the St. James Theater. It's a, No, I wouldn't do that. We have a terrific one. Gee, you all look so dressed up and chic and sophisticated, huh? Speak right out, madam. What is it? Mayor Koch did what? The Moyd Griffin Show. I'm back in New York. Moyd welcomes you, madam. We have a show today that reflects this great city and how everything starts here and then the rest of the world gets it. You're going to be vastly entertained here today. The big news for next season on Broadway is the return of my first guest, who's about to come out here, the most exciting dancing, singing actress I know of in our business. She's going to be starring in a brand new musical called Bye Bye Birdie 2. It's the first time a sequel has ever been done of a hit Broadway musical in the history of Broadway, because we all fondly remember Bye Bye Birdie, in which she starred with Dick Van Dyke. Right now, she's going to recreate for you one of her greatest moments on Broadway, because she's been in a lot of hit shows. The hit show she's going to recreate right now for you is Chicago, which was written by John Kander and Fred Ebb, and she's going to do all that jazz, the big number. With her friends here, ladies and gentlemen, is Miss Chita Rivera. Bravo!
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car, I know I won't be smart. Where the gin is cold, but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. Yeah. Oh, slick your hair and wear your buckle shoes. Da-da-da-da. And all that jazz, I hear that Father Dick is gonna blow. And want a brand new start to do that
jazz. Oh, you're gonna see a shiva shimmy shake.
And all that jazz.
Oh, she's gonna shimmy till her garters break.
No, I'm no one's wife.
that check.
Follow the leader. Okay, here we go. I say rotten things about me, and I really hate them an awful lot. That's all I know. Chita Rivera. Gray Leland. Mike. I love you. We'll be right back after this message.
Are your basement windows going to be burglarized tonight? Hardy glass block panels could prevent it. Here's why.
Glass block windows come pre-assembled to fit your basement, garage, bathroom, wherever. Optional vents let air in. The mortar seals water out. Glass block does all this and helps keep out the burglars.
Stop burglars and vandalism. Call Hardy glass block panels. Call now, 779-6600. 779-6600.
Tonight at 10 on MASH, a heating fuel shortage makes strange bedfellows.
Good night, girls.
Good night, Major.
Good night, Major.
Killing her! Out!
Then at 10:30, the chase is on. MASH at 10 and the Benny Hill Show at 10:30, tonight on Channel 32.
Curly-headed devil, look at her, huh?
Well, it's natural.
She had it done the last time we did a show. How long ago was that, a year?
Oh, gosh. No, not the very last one. About 5 years ago or something. My hair's naturally curly, right? And so for years I've been lying on the ironing board.
Ironing away,
you know,
right?
Just trying to iron the curls out of my head for so many years. And so I find it, that Vidal Sassoon said, Chita, I think you should wear your hair natural. And I went, I can't. People will stare. So he sat me under a little thing and with heat and stuff, you know, and cut it and everything. And then I kind of liked it, but then I came to your show.
Yeah.
I was not at all sure. And I stepped out and you looked, took one look at me and said, Chita, what in the world did you do to your head? Did you stick your hand in a socket? And well, that's all I needed. I went right out and straightened my hair.
No, I love it.
No, I didn't.
You look like a Latin Shirley Temple.
Thank you. Yep. Thank you.
It's wonderful to see you.
Oh, it's always so nice to see you.
Do you know that you were the subject of a long conversation a short time ago here on our show? Mr. Nureyev was on.
Oh.
So in the middle of the conversation, I said to him, Mr. Nureyev, do you know Chita Rivera? Oh, yes, I know Chita. I said, you know that song that she sings that Fred Ebb and John Kander wrote for her, act called Pain? He said, Pain? And I said, yeah, it's all about dancers when they're smiling and selling and laughing with the audience, the terrible pains that are going on in their body, just like a few minutes ago. He said, oh, pain. I said, do you have pains, Mr. Nureyev? He admitted.
Well,
so
yes.
I have pains all my life, all over my body.
You just get used to that pain.
Yeah?
You just, well, you know. Well, you have perfected your dancing, by
the way. Yeah, there's no pain to that at all. No. You notice I didn't puff at all, and they're all going behind me. I just do it easily.
Wait till you wake up tomorrow morning with the pain.
Oh.
Yes, you'll know.
Violent pains?
Sometimes,
dancing?
Sure, sometimes. Terrible pains. I mean, you get up and you're crooked, you know. And you walk around for a while and get in the shower, and then you feel a little better until you... Gwen Verdon and I always say, as long as we can still pick them up and put them down, we're okay. That's this.
Those are legs. Oh, yeah.
We're still alive. I swear. Oh, I'm sorry. I swear that one day, I hope and pray to God it never happens, that I'm going to wake up and it's all going to be on the bed. You know what I mean?
You won't be there, but so all the...
I will be up, but my extensions, my pliés, my dan, everything's going to be still there, and it's going to go no more. I've had enough.
No.
You're not going to get me up anymore.
Oh, never, Chita. You'll dance to the... The day you go.
Oh, yeah, I'll be dancing with the Greeks and dancing with the... I don't know, I'll go someplace and do
something. Is it your whole life?
No. Show business is my... No. I love dancing, Elmer.
Could you ever stop?
When I have to,
is it
to,
so
sure.
consuming to you?
I
Even
just
with
love
the pain? Because the obvious question is, if there's pain, why don't you quit?
Yeah, but there's different kinds of pain, you know? I mean, you know that when you're stretching that leg, and even though it hurts, it's pretty... You know,
yeah.
you just have such respect for the gift that you're given and an obligation to continue as long and do the best with it that you can and with what you get back from these wonderful people,
yeah.
You know. And then to have kids come up and say, I love to dance, please tell me what should I do. It's a wonderful feeling. It's an extension of the
How
spirit.
Did you feel the night?
Thank you for understanding.
I just had a terrible thought. Wouldn't it be awful if there was pain to applauding?
Well, there was when Jack Cole was one of our greatest choreographers, and he made Marilyn Monroe dance, and he was
right.
Betty Grable, absolutely brilliant, Carol Haney, Gwen Verdon, Matt Maddox, the great dancers of this country, and he used to have a clap because he did East Indian work also, and there was a certain way you had to clap, and if you didn't clap that way. Well, I'm cute.
You're
a few
out,
kicks
right?
and a few was thrown around a little bit. But I mean, you had to. Now, that's wrong. But you would spend 2 and 3 hours doing this. That's right. If there's an echo, if you hit your hand in the right place. So, for. Wrong. So, you would stay for 3 hours doing this. Nope. 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 Yes. There is a sound that is the right sound. It's like a musical instrument.
Well, let's rehearse this crowd, shall we?
No,
suppose, though, the first person who ever applauded didn't do this. Suppose it was...
Well, I
we
could
wouldn't
use
be
little
getting...
of that. No, people hit things, and people make... What about the Pope when he was here with the children? There was a verbal sound. There was, you know...
What was that sound?
Oh, it was wonderful. It was his understanding of the children, his a release of love.
What was the sound?
Oh, I can't. Was it ooh?
Ooh,
ooh, ooh. That was it.
The Pope went ooh.
Yes, he did. He did, and the children understood, and this child at home understood. It was wonderful. So, this is one way. This is another way.
And woo, woo.
And woo, woo. It was the best.
Yeah, yeah. Are you born and reared in New York?
No, Washington D.C.
Ah, one applaud. Thank you, Mr. Carter. Finally left the White House, huh? Fun growing up there? Not exactly showbiz.
No.
Showbiz in another sense.
Well, it was a Puerto Rican family, five of us. So our family was everything, you know. So we did it. We had movies in the basement, and I would do my splits. That was the show.
What'd your dad do?
My father was a musician. He died when we were very young. So mother was left with the five children when she was quite young. Mother was, I guess, about 28 or 29.
Were you just a social dancer in those days, kind of going
No, I was studying. I was studying.
Doing all the Bobby Sox
things? Acrobatics and stuff, you know, all that sort of stuff. But we had a full and wonderful family life. I mean, baseball and everything, you know. The girls were playing, doing the boys' games, and we were just...
How old were you when you came to New York?
15. Went to Taft.
All by yourself?
Taft? No, really? I love it. Taft High School.
All by yourself, or did the family...
No, mother... put me, it's so funny talking about me. I hate talking about myself. I do, boring.
No, it's not.
Mother put me in a school and with a very nice family here. And made me promise I wouldn't dance all over the furniture. It was the only thing I had to do was dance. And then I had won a scholarship to New York City Ballet Company.
What was your first role on Broadway?
That was the Road Company, Call Me Ma'am. On Broadway was a replacement of Anna White in Guys and Dolls.
Did you know that you had made it once you got on Broadway?
Never. Made what?
I mean, you hit Broadway. You're bound to be a star.
All I wanted to do was dance. That's all I wanted to do is just dance. And so you don't. I heard Bette Midler say yesterday morning, I'm having a good year. You know, that's what it is.
So you're prepared for a bad year and another good year?
Sure,
and
you are. Sure.
I want to know about, this is the first time it's ever been done on Broadway. They revived a show and made it a sequel. Bye Bye Birdie 2. Now, if I remember, it was you and Dick Van Dyke.
Right, and Kay Medford.
And Kay Medford, right.
Paul Lynde,
right. And
Susan Watson. But now we have Lee Goober's producing it. Michael Stewart, whose Barnum just opened, is writing it.
And it takes the story years after.
Yes, it's 20 years later.
And
it's
what happened
Rosie
to everybody?
Rosie and Albert 20 years later. Their two kids have grown up. Well, they're 15 and 16. And it's the problems with their two kids rather than the McAfee's children.
And where's the
Roxanne? Conrad Birdie's now about 44, 45. He's fat. And he's now the mayor of a town in Arizona, and he wants to be a respectable person. But what he has not done was that he hasn't really gotten rid of that gold suit. It's stuck away somewhere. You see, so we're trying to, well, Albert is trying to get him back to do one television show, sort of like what Dick Clark did years ago with getting certain people back. And we have to find him. I don't want to do it, but Albert wants to. And it's a lot of trouble, and our children have gotten into... my daughter's in the Hare Krishna, and my son is in a rock band. So, you know, it's...
Just a run-of-the-mill family life.
Well, right? Yes, today.
Yeah, today it is.
So it's very much like...
We look forward to that.
Today.
I'm going to take a break and come back with one of the most important teams Broadway has ever known right after this message.
Presents the 40 greatest hits of Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons. Now, all the greatest hits of Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons in a fantastic double album collector's edition from Imperial House. Valley in the Four Seasons, a giant two-record collection of hits that made them international superstars.
Working my way back to you, babe.
Performing with the Four Seasons, or as a solo act, Frankie Valli continues to be a dominant force in the music world. Record collection is complete without this giant two-record anthology from Imperial House. The 40 greatest hits of Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Here's how to order yours.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-453-8800. That's 1-800-453-8800. Or save COD charge. Send $9.99 for two LPs, $11.99 for two 8-tracks or cassettes to Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. Box 11132, Chicago, Illinois, 60611. Or call 1-800-453-8800 and charge it.
Tonight at 10:30, Benny Hill looks at the issues of contemporary life, such as ethics of modern medicine.
Do you realize 12 months ago you told I only had a year to live? Ooh!
Or marital breakup in the 80s.
That was never a penalty, never!
Or man-woman relationships. It's all for laughs on The Benny Hill Show, tonight at 10:30 on Channel 32.
As they walk out here, I am going to have our staff play Frank Sinatra's recording, which is fast climbing for him. It's been a long time since he's had one in the top 10, and this is shooting right to the top of the list, which is great. And of course, it's the song they wrote, and you'll recognize. Here are the composer and lyricist John Kander and Fred Ebb. That is the definitive New York song, ain't it?
Well, I hope so. Thanks.
And are you thrilled it's going to the top 10?
Yeah.
Pep,
how do you know?
Will you pep? Because we had a man on here whose name is Cal Rudman, and he has 93% accuracy. He sends a sheet that they use subscribe to all the radio stations, and he has picked it, and it's zooming to the top. You're going to make New York famous.
Good for him.
I hope he's right.
Huh?
I hope he's right.
Did you know that that would become such a lasting song when you wrote it and so much a part of the city?
No.
You just thought it was a great song for that movie?
Huh? No.
You don't even like it, do you?
Yeah, I like it. But yes. I mean, you do your best. You never know.
Do you know the last time we saluted Fred Ebb, he came on the show?
Fainted.
Fainted and forgot every lyric he wrote? I'm standing next to him going, we're leaving the town.
I did.
Once you write them, do you wipe them out?
Somewhat, but they come back to you. We've rehearsed today.
A lot of good that'll do, Fred.
That's right, right out of the head.
The inevitable question, which comes
together.
First?
I'm sorry, the question is which comes first, the words and music?
Yeah.
We write together in the same room at the same time.
Do you ever say to him, I like the rhyme, June and Moon, and he says, change that melody to hmm, 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 hmm.
All the time.
Does it steam you?
No, we're very good together. We have a very good time writing. Everything else is sort of bad, but writing is terrific.
Is this the perfect town to write in?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried writing in California?
Yeah.
Does it work?
No.
Why?
Well,
chauvinists.
It's true.
Why is? Because you generally live somewhere and there's like a swimming pool out there winking at you.
Yeah.
And there's the sun and tennis courts and things. And there's all these other things you'd rather do. So writing is work. And I'd rather play than work. And out there, there's more temptation to do that. Here you look out the window, you just see somebody getting mugged. I mean, you know.
And you quickly write a song?
No, you particularly don't want to go out. I mean, it's, it's where you work. So
sure.
And you're used to working here.
But tell the truth, do you own a home in California?
Yeah.
Sure you do, sure. Using our state as an investment, right?
Well, it just seemed like a good idea at the time. Johnny's mother said it would lengthen my life, so I bought it.
She said
you bought a house out there, but you live here?
Yeah. Well, I rent that.
I don't know how that's going to lengthen your life, right?
She promised him.
Yeah.
He bought it immediately.
That's right.
The songs, we're going to hear some songs a little later on in the medley you're going to do. But there were songs long before Broadway. There were songs that you wrote for, just as pop hits, for stars, coloring book.
Yes.
Yeah, great. But this is the joy of your life. Is your life good here in town,
yeah, it's
Fred?
It's wonderful.
Do you pick up sounds of the city that infiltrate your music?
I would.
Hey,
I don't
mister!
Know, probably.
Huh?
Probably. Yeah. When it's very quiet, I can't sleep, for example.
Are you intimidated by the stars you work with?
Constantly.
Are you?
Yes.
No, I'm not.
Freddie's much better about that.
But I mean, you grew up.
I'm not. I wasn't intimidated by you.
Oh.
No, I was. I don't think so.
Liza Minnelli, well, she's like family, right?
Yeah, she's like your kid sister. But I mean, they're like, they're people, and generally. Anything you've heard about them isn't accurate anyway.
Yeah.
So it's better off not hearing about them, just accepting them as you meet them. And I think most of them are terrific people.
Do you have any fears of working with the great Lauren Bacall and that fabulous voice of hers?
Well, she lives in the neighborhood.
Oh, so you're just writing for a kid in the neighborhood.
That's
right?
Really right.
She's an Upper West Side girl.
At this moment, you have a revival running, The Happy Time.
Right.
And where is it?
It's at the Goodspeed Opera House in East Hanover.
Oh, that's a big deal now,
yeah,
isn't it?
It's a wonderful place.
Who's starring in it?
Joe Maciel.
Right.
And they're really not, the cast is not well-known people. On Broadway, it was Bob Goulet and David Wayne.
Yeah.
big deal. But that's a rather small place. That's a 400-seat house, very beautiful. It's on a river.
Right.
And it's wonderful to see a show again. It was 12 years ago.
Oh, I love that show. I saw the original show on Broadway.
With oh, that's nice. It's real Bob. Small now.
I think everybody would enjoy getting you ready here for a medley of your best-known songs, ones we've all been singing for a long time. And you're going to hear that after we come back from this commercial break. Fred Ebb and John Kander.
Good evening, everybody. The Regional Transportation Authority isn't out of the woods yet. RTA Finance Committee Chairman Pat O'Malley warns that the agency will have to cut service by 16% unless the legislature okays granting aid to the RTA before it adjourns on Monday. The city of Chicago won't be aiding tenants that think they're victims of rent gouging. Today, the city council voted to kill the measure that would have created a fair rent commission in the city.
I'm chewing gum again. It's wonderful. For years, I couldn't because gum stuck to my dental work. But now there's Freedent gum. It doesn't stick, so I can enjoy all the pleasures of chewing gum again. The delicious flavor, fresh, clean breath, and refreshing taste. All that's possible again with Freedent gum from Wrigley's. It comes in peppermint and spearmint. You'll love it.
Feel free to chew Freedent.
It won't stick to most dental work.
Freedent gum.
I'm Kathy McFarland, and I'll have a wrap-up of all today's news at 9:55 here on Channel 32.
Here are the great songs as written by Fred Ebb and John Kander.
Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time he'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. Well, all the odds are in my favor. Something's bound to begin. It's Liza with a Z, not Lisa with an S, cause Lisa with an S goes nuts. It's Z instead of S, it's Lie instead of Lee, it's simple as can be. See, Liza.
These are the eyes that watched him as he walked away. Color them gray. This is the man who love I depended upon. Color him gone.
What good is sitting alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. It's only a cabaret. Shoulder and a smile on my lips. How lucky to be. Money in my pocket, right at my fingertips. How lucky. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. Part of this New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of this New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill.
Better give you a medal for that one. It makes everybody want to come back here.
One medal to lose if ever threw it.
Yeah. At the moment you got going, when they started screaming there, did you think for a minute you were Sinatra or Liza Minnelli? Did you? Because the arms went out, the chair went over, huh? Yeah.
Where do you think they got it from?
I get carried away.
Do you?
Oh, you thank you all very much.
Thank you. You do from here?
Yeah.
Chita Rivera has been a star for you two fellas on several occasions. You've written her nightclub act, and of course you wrote Chicago.
Yep.
Which had a nice long run, not only here on Broadway, but all over
the
United States.
Yes.
What are you going to do?
Well, we're going to do something from The Happy Time, a beautiful ballad that I do in the act, actually. And
right.
It is from the show at Goodsby.
Great.
I think it's really pretty.
Chita Rivera.
I don't remember you. I don't remember you. I don't recall a single thing we used to say or do. What dancing in the park, what laughter in the dark, what smoldering fireplace that lit your face with every spark. And if you left me once before, somehow I can't recall it anymore. That was another time, that was another place. And though you bear a faint resemblance, you're another face. Yes, I was wrong. This moment is new. Because I can't, I won't, I don't remember you. What picnics by the mill? What race across the hill? What footsteps in the snow I heard below my windowsill? And if you left me once before, somehow I can't recall it anymore. Oh, that was another time, that was another place. And though you bear a faint resemblance, you're another face. Yes, I was wrong. I can't, I won't, I don't remember you.
Chita Rivera, the song from The Happy Time, currently at the Goodspeed Opera House in East Haddam, Connecticut. John, a million thanks to you. Wonderful to have you here. Thank you, Fred Ebb. You've given us great songs, and we'll never forget you for them. Thank you. We'll be right back after this message.